Muncie.
HD3 Detroit.
KJAQ.
HD3 Seattle.
WBMX.
HD3 Boston. And on AOL Radio and Yahoo Launchcast. Psychic Radio is now CBS Radio's The Sky. Back to Behind the Paranormal with Paul and Ben Eno. Call now 248-545-SOUL. New skyradio.com.
Let's start with our questions, basically, really, we're going to look at tonight. How much do the so-called paranormal experts we see around us really know? Can they be trusted? Is there a place where people can get a reliable paranormal education?
Hey, and welcome to the 118th edition of Behind the Paranormal with Paul and Benino. I'm Ben, and opening the show was my dad, co-host and partner in the paranormal, my dad.
That's me. All three of our guests today are from the beautiful state of West Virginia, one of my favorite places. Deborah Lindsey is president of the new International Metaphysical University, which opened last September 21st. Deborah is an expert and teacher in, among other things, alternative healing. She has advanced training in the Jaffe Meller technique, emotional freedom technique. Deborah has completed a great deal of other advanced training. And what does it mean when a group of you... Okay, well, we got a problem. This can't be the right bar. Anyway, she's a very accomplished paranormal expert and is president of International Metaphysical University. Middle like Kitchell wrote this script. Susan Shepherd is dean of paranormal studies at IMU. She is a paranormal investigator, author, and respected psychic medium, one of the few that I am used to working with.
Oh, all right. And she is a psychic medium, one of the few of my dad's, as my dad would say, he'd work with them. She is from West Virginia, and in her childhood, she has been born with an interest with the paranormal. Susan grew up just a few hills away from the first sighting of the famous West Virginia Mothman. At that time, her family home underwent a great deal of paranormal activity. Since she was a teenager, Susan has been doing psychic readings and working with the police on missing person cases. She has written a number of books and has been featured on ABC Family's channel, popular show Scariest Places on Earth, and a number of other U.S. and Canadian TV shows. She is one of the world's foremost experts on Mothman, Intrigue Cold, and the Men in Black, and she'll be on our October 18th show to talk about that soon.
Well, she'll be a show very soon. I'm sorry, I stepped on your lines there, Ben. Dr. Steve Russell is the pro... I'm afraid.
There you go. It just happened now.
Well, you stepped on mine. Dr. Steve Russell is the provost and chief academic officer at IMU. He oversees the development of all academic programs and degrees. Dr. Russell previously served as the CEO for the Instructional Technical Technology Solutions and Services Group in Parkersburg, West Virginia, where he provided corporate leadership to colleges and universities in the areas of accreditation, distance education, curriculum design, faculty development. He has developed online learning accreditation proposals through, I should say, that were approved by the North Central Association's Commission on Accreditation and School Improvement, and also the Accrediting Council for Independent Colleges and Schools. Hope you're writing all this down. Dr. Russell has headed various programs and designed graduate and undergraduate courses at several colleges and universities. He received his doctorate in special education with a minor in higher education administration from West Virginia University in 1993. And IMU's website, www.intermetu.com.
Welcome to Behind the Paranormal.
Hi, everybody. Are you with us?
I'm here.
Sure are.
Okay, great. Little rough start there, but let me just remind everybody our call-in numbers here on CBS New Sky Radio this evening, newskyradio.com, 248-545-SOUL or 545-7685. Or if you're listening on a computer, use the nifty instant feedback feature to the right of the newskyradio.com homepage as you listen live. Now, okay, let's talk about paranormal education. And Ben, I guess, is going to start us off.
Yes. All right. Deborah, everywhere you look on the internet, there's somebody offering courses in ghost hunting or psychic power. So why is IMU so different?
Well, it's a really good question, and I think that the internet is a fantastic resource for getting information, and that it's terrific that that kind of information is out there nowadays. The thing about IMU, and a lot of the reason that we're offering a degree in this, is that we really seek to go out and find the very best, most credible instructors in the world to teach our courses. And so you're getting really comprehensive classes, and you're getting comprehensive classes from people who are truly experts in the field. Most of them, I mean, like Paul, are people who are hugely respected, who have written books and who have been doing this stuff for 20, 25 years. You know, one of the dangers of this community is that there's a lot of people who go out and they take a weekend class and they consider themselves an expert, and then they go out and start teaching it, and then that sort of information is what becomes the standard. And, you know, when people start teaching that as if it's some sort of, you know, some sort of advanced teaching, which often it really isn't. So the other thing about IMU and getting, you know, like actually working towards a degree is that you're getting a wide breadth of information. You can, you know, learn about ghost hunting techniques, but you're also going to learn about, you know, all of the different aspects of that, not just, you know, what is an EVP and how to do that. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah. Yeah, and I must confess to the audience, I myself teach at IMU, albeit so far one active course, the Paranormal and Religion and Science. Now, let me read you a quote, okay, which I think might point out some issues that IMU has to overcome in order to get credibility. Now, quote, "If ever there was a field that has worked overtime to achieve the label pseudoscience, it is paranormal research in the early 21st century. While there are a pitifully small number of credible scientists, trained philosophers, and experienced researchers, the field is overrun with young amateurs, showmen, and outright charlatans. While clinging to the dreary dogmas of the 19th century spiritualism, the latter three convince the media and the public that they are experts, write laughable books, confer on each other awards, certifications, and fake academic degrees, and generally perfect the art of shallow thinking. They make what should be the most important field of study in human history into a punchline." Unquote. Very cynical, but how do you respond to that?
Well, that is the reason I don't watch very many of the ghost shows on television because they annoy me so much because a number of reasons. You know, they're based upon trying to scare people. And people that have had encounters with the spirit world, you know, after you've had these encounters, you realize it really is not a frightening thing. It usually happens very quickly. It's memorable. It happens quickly. Goes away, and you don't really have time to be scared. But they have to sell these television shows.
Oh, yeah.
And so if they're going to be taking out these academic scientific people or even a psychic medium like myself who's not going to roll my eyes around and have strange voices come out of me, that's not real entertaining for most people.
That's true. You are very grounded. I was, and I met, because we've known each other for some years now, and I was.
Right.
I was prepared for the worst, but I was very impressed. You have your feet on the ground. You're a clear thinker. It was wonderful to meet you and to know you. And Deborah, I don't know you as well, but I mean, you certainly have your feet on the ground too. Is Steve with us? I want to compliment him.
Yeah, he never called the station, so he's still on our.
We'll try to get him back during the break.
Yeah, we'll force him to do it.
Okay.
I'm on the line.
Oh, you are? Okay.
Hi. Yeah, that's what I said. He's on the line.
Okay. Yeah, but Ben's our engineer here. Here at our end. Anyway, okay, well, Steve, I don't know if I'll have you speak because when you call in, can you call into the studio during the break? We'll see if we can't get a clearer audio here on you. Okay, so in any case, okay, I got you. Yep,
can I comment to that last section too? Well,
by all means, Deborah, I'm sorry.
I think that the quote that you said had some real legitimacy to it. And that is that so many people teach this, treat this field as if somehow it's, it's either perceived as a joke, or it's perceived as something that's, it's just not something that's taken very seriously. And the thing is, you know, what the quote said was that this is some of the most important information out there in the world, and it really deserves. Legitimate scientific research, and it deserves the kind of place in academia that you would give to, say, an English class. You know, I know that for me, when I started really realizing from my own experience that there was life after death, and that, you know, and that there is so much going on beyond the veil that we can see. I live my life differently. I don't live my life with the same kind of fear of death or the fear of the other side that I used to, which is why Susan's point about, you know, everybody promulgating the fear of the paranormal is so relevant. You know, this information is information that changes the quality of your whole life and literally has the capacity to change the way we see the entire world. It changes the way we see religion. It changes the way we see how we live our lives. You know, it's really important information.
Absolutely. Well, I wanted
and
to get
it's
in.
Also very. Go ahead.
Go ahead, Susan. I'm sorry, please.
Oh no, there's and ghost hunters and investigators come from different philosophies, different viewpoints.
Yes.
Some may come from a religious viewpoint, others may come from a purely scientific viewpoint. I mean, in a way, you could almost when you talk about place hauntings and residual hauntings and imprints and things like that, you could almost be an atheist and be a ghost hunter and explain it by some other means. So
I know
so
some.
Different sides. Pardon me?
I know some. Yeah.
Yeah, right. Exactly. But
they're all relevant perspectives.
Yeah, they are.
Right,
they
exactly.
are. You know, and there's no.
Yeah, exactly.
Which brings up the question of peer review. Now, I will get into this with Steve. Hopefully, we'll get him after the break here. But the whole idea, there's something about peer review. And what peer review is, of course, as you know, is in standard academic life, you have peers in your science or in your profession who review what you do, compare it with what they are. And they kind of keep people from going hog wild. Now, I don't know if that applies. I mean, in a way, you could look at the state of paranormal research today and think, heaven, there isn't any peer review. But, I mean, I'm joking. But I mean, if we did have that, it would maybe lend some more credibility. But in any case, we have to take a break right now, and we'll be right back with our guests on Behind the Paranormal with Paul and Ben Eno. Stay with us.
Be sure to check out Breakthrough with A.J. Barrera, Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern on The Sky. Breakthrough with A.J. Barrera will feature world-renowned experts in the body-mind-spirit fields, authors, celebrities, conversations about personal life issues in today's society, and intuitive readings by A.J. Barrera. It's a show that'll transform lives. Breakthrough with A.J. Barrera, Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern, live on The Sky.
CBS Radio's The New Sky. Believe. NewSkyRadio.com.
Now that I've lost everything to you, you say you want to start something new, and it's breaking my heart you're leaving. Maybe I'm grieving, but if you want to leave, take good care. Hope you have a lot of nice things to wear, but then a lot of nice things turn back. Remember, there's a lot of bad, and beware.
remember you like a child girl.
Psychic Radio is now CBS Radio's The Sky.
Back to Behind the Paranormal
with Paul and Ben Eno.
Call now
248-545-SOUL.
New skyradio.com. Believe.
And we're back. It's Paul and Ben here, along with Deborah Lindsey of the International Metaphysical University, Susan Shepherd of IMU. And I believe we finally have our third guest, Steve Russell. Are you with us, Steve?
I'm here.
Okay, sounds pretty good. All right, Steve, I wanted to get your reaction to some of the things we've been talking about. The audio wasn't too good before the break. What's your approach to getting this school accredited? There's been a lot of problems with a lot of people teaching things and handing out degrees, and the institutions are not accredited, and they don't get any respect. But IMU, you're working very hard to get accredited as an officially recognized university by the U.S. Department of Education, and that to me, is a fantastic goal to do, and something that would be great. How are you going about it? How are you going to go about the problem of peer review and all the things they require? Just tell us what the process might be and how we might be able to accomplish it.
Okay, the process begins with the United States Department of Education. They do not accredit schools, but they give approval to agencies who do accredit schools. And the agency that we are looking for accreditation through is the Distance Education Training Council. It's one of the national organizations the Department of Education approves. And they basically deal with schools who use online methods or some type of a distant method. The problem, as you brought up before the break, with peer review is that there are no institutions who can be considered peer reviewers based on the type of studies that we have. The closest that we have would be, you know, schools who have paranormal psychology programs, for instance. And so our approach is to follow the guidelines for the Distance Education Training Council in developing standards that we would consider to be industry standards for each of the areas that we offer degrees in, and then create portfolios for our professors to make sure that they are, accredible professors, people who are, you know, tops in their field, whether they have a degree or they have significant experience, people who have written books, people who have, done extensive workshop work, that type of thing. And so we look at faculty, we look at how the courses are developed, we look at the standards within the courses, and then we put those together, and the portfolio is sent to DETC, and then they come in, and after about a year of offering classes, and they look to see what we're doing.
Okay, very good. Now, this is a question for all of you. I guess we can start probably with Deborah. How do you go about finding the outstanding faculty that seems to be working with IMU now? Now, you line 10 people up on the street, 5 of them are going to claim to be experts. But how did you go about finding the and tell us some of the people who teach with IMU and how you were able to get hold of them?
Well, one of the things that we did from the very early days of the planning of the college was we knew that we wanted to have the very best in the industry teaching for us. So that was one of the criteria that we went in with. And when we put together our team, including the deans with people like Susan, we went after people who knew who who the leaders were in the industry. So if it's a field that I don't know very well, I can always go to my dean, and my dean knows who in the field is credible and who isn't. Mm-hmm. We look for people who have best-selling books. We look for people who have mainstream degrees, and we look for people who have a lot of credibility in the field. And this is across the board with all of our programs, because we have 6 different programs that we're offering at IMU. We have of course, the degree in paranormal studies, but we also have a degree in shamanic anthropology. We have a degree in energy and alternative medicine. We have a degree in consciousness studies for people who are interested in just exploring a variety of areas. We have a degree in intuitive arts, and we also have a degree program in ufology. And ufology is the first degree program of its type in the world. Mm-hmm. And particularly with something like the ufology program, it was critical that we found people who are who are credentialed in the field. So you get somebody like, you know, we have like Paula Harris, who is world famous as an investigative journalist, and we have Rebecca Hardcastle, who is the founder of Exoconsciousness, and we have Stanton Friedman, who has written so many books that I don't even know how many it is, and we've even talked to people like Zechariah Sitchin, who's not teaching for us yet, but has indicated that he will, who is sort of the founder of the field.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the quality of people that we're going for. As far as the teachers in the Paranormal Studies program, I think Susan could talk to that, since she's the dean of the program.
Susan,
well,
go for
generally,
it.
Just it's people that I know that I like yourself, past met through different paranormal conferences or authors like Rosemary Ellen Guiley, who's gotten I think 40 some books out and is very.
I believe it's well over 40. Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, my department's kind of a grab bag, so I have a lot of different kinds of people in my my department, you know, with an emphasis on ghost hunting and a little bit, touching a little bit on the Men in Black and the West Virginia Mothman, and then Rosemary's going to be teaching a couple of classes we're going to be putting up here pretty soon on vampires and werewolves.
Cool.
And so that's going to be a fun thing. It's going to be very interesting. And, you know, she approaches it as a scholar. She's looked at all this. She's gone to Eastern Europe. She studied these cases. And so, you know, she looked at it from a scholarly view. And I think that that's very important with our instructors. And we like to see people that who do have popular books. And if they don't have popular books, you know, a lot of people have experience. And it shows on websites or, you know, in lifestyle. You know, they travel around and perhaps, you know, work in ghost hunting, but they've not yet written a book. We're looking at someone out in California that has a lot of experience with exorcism and banishments, and so we're looking into that as well. So it's people that have been established for a long, long time, and many of them are recognizable names, and a lot of these people you're going to see on television programs like Stanton Friedman and Rosemary Ellen Guiley, and they're world-class experts.
Well,
you,
a lot of them are around. They have been on this show, and you're providing
right.
us with an endless supply of outstanding guests. And thank you very much,
right.
Steve. Any comments on that?
I think that the people that Susan has attracted and the people that all the deans have attracted are either well known in their field or they're part of a continuum that I think is important. You know, when I was at the UFO Congress conference last week in Nevada, we talked about the continuum. That spread across the silly to the serious. And I think that, you know, in higher education, you need a little bit of each end and a lot in the middle. And I think that's what we're getting. We're getting people who are serious about, you know, investigation. And there's some who basically, you know, are into folklore and, you know, the interesting fun stuff about ghosts and ghost huntings and hauntings.
Excellent. Well, as I say, our guest lineup is working its way through the whole faculty here. Just remind everybody here that our phone number today, 248-545-SOUL or 545-7685. Or if you're listening on a computer, use the instant feedback feature to the right of your screen. Now, Ben has a... Yeah, please.
Oh. I wanted to mention, just since I have the opportunity, that Rosemary Ellen Guiley is actually going to be teaching at our location in West Virginia, March 20th and 21st. If anybody's interested in traveling down our way to see her in person, she's going to be here actually teaching her course on werewolves and vampires and so forth. It's actually going to be taught here live, so people could come here and take the course live and still get credit for having taken the course through the university and you know, interact with her directly.
Well, Rosemary also is, we've gotten to know her pretty well through, thanks to the introduction through IMU. And I haven't known a lot of these people because I don't go to a lot of conferences, and it's been wonderful to get to know them. And Rosemary even is going to be a guest host from time to time on this show. So
terrific, fantastic.
Well, she lives in Connecticut, and we're in Rhode Island, so she can come over to our Saturday show, which we do out of a regular radio studio. And so we're going to be doing some of that, and she's been a tremendous resource. So anyway, Ben has a question for everybody.
That I do. I'm used to sitting in classrooms with a lot of give and take between students and teachers. That's a lie. With an online school, you recover from any of that? Or any of that?
I'll take that one if it's okay.
Sure, go for it.
It's true that the interaction, the student-teacher interaction, is not the same as it is in a live classroom. But the online universities are becoming so sophisticated nowadays that there's great opportunities for interaction between both students and student-teachers. And in some ways, I think it's even more advanced, particularly in this field, because you get to talk to people all over the world instead of just people who happen to be right in your own community. But through IMU, you know, you can do Skyping and you can do forums and you can do conference calls and chat lists. There's an endless variety of communication tools that you can use for interacting with, you know, both the student and the teacher. You know, and, you know, for today's audience, too, you know, young people today in particular, I mean, sometimes they don't even have a community of their own. They don't go hang out at the sock hop or whatever anymore. Now they're online. That's where their communities are online, Facebook and chat lists and that sort of thing. That's how communities are made nowadays.
Well, I must say that I want to give Susan a chance to address this, but my last student was someone I was in a rare position. He lives literally around the corner from here. So not only did we have a chance to interact in the normal manner, but I could just, you know, we could just exchange visits. It was perfect. But I don't expect too much of that. But anyway, right. Go ahead, Susan. You're welcome to respond to that.
Well, you know, we also do a lot of interesting things. I was sitting here thinking about last fall, for instance, we put on a dumb supper. Do you know what a dumb supper is?
No, that's got to be a West Virginia term.
Oh, no, it's Irish Welsh. It's an old tradition.
Oh, I'm sorry.
They made it to the Appalachian Mountains, and
we're Yankees.
To put on that.
Say. Yeah. Okay.
Go ahead.
No. You said you put that on. Was that for the?
Yeah, we were able to actually, you know, tape that and videotape that and record something that's almost not practiced anymore. And it has to do with Halloween and has to do with spirits of the dead and that sort of thing.
Cool.
And we went ahead and put this dumb supper on. A story that I had about it, very interesting, came out of the hills of Roane County, West Virginia. And that there was just recording important folklore that would be lost if it were our university. Because if you go to YouTube and you look up dumb suppers, they're not correct. And we tried to do it in a correct, you know, kind of way. So, you know, we want it to be authentic and genuine and dot all of our I's and cross all of our T's and make sure that it's done right. And the interaction with students is also very, very important, you know, through chat and emails.
Yeah.
But I think Susan brought up a good point, which is that you can also go and take a lot of these classes live. You know, so if you're someone who enjoys taking weekend workshops, and you know that one of our instructors is teaching a workshop somewhere, you can actually go and take the course live and then submit for credit through IMU.
Interesting. Okay.
So, and we also have a.
I'm afraid I have to interrupt you. We got to wrap for another break, but we'll be right back behind the paranormal on CBS New Sky Radio and newskyradio.com. Stay with us.
Psychic Radio.
Para X with Dave and Tommy Jones
on Psychic Radio.
This is Dave.
And this is Tom. And if you want to hear everything about paranormal, ghosts, spirits, UFO, you've got to tune into your radio show.
Don't guess. Tune in and you'll find out all about it. That's every Sunday, 8 until 10 p.m. Eastern on Para X Radio on Psychic Radio, powered by CBS.
Psychic Radio.
PsychicOnAir.com.
We know you're listening.
Look for Psychic Radio on your AOL radio player.
Psychic Radio.
24 hours a day.
Reach out from beyond to your ears.
On the web now. Log on to PsychicOnAir.com. Your spiritual well-being is our concern. This
is Psychic Radio.
Powered online by AOL at PsychicOnAir.com.
We know you're listening.
I miss the
And I miss the still of the silence as you breathe out. Down hard and drown me in love. I miss the sound of your voice, the loudest thing in my head. And I ache to remember all the violent, sweet, perfect words that you said. If I could walk on water, if I could tell you what's next.
The Sky.
Back to Behind the Paranormal
with Paul and Ben Eno.
Call now
248-545-SOUL. New skyradio.com.
Okay, and we are back with our guests from the International Metaphysical University, Deborah Lindsey, Susan Shepherd, and Steve Russell, Dr. Steve Russell. Now, Steve, how did the guy with your background get involved with a project like this? You're distinguished academic background and attempting to turn this into a distinguished paranormal institution. How did you get involved with this? Uh-oh.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I got you. Yep.
Okay. I was in academic administration. I was a dean at Marshall University in West Virginia and Ohio Valley University. And I was one of the pioneers in online education, and not only developing it, but selling it to colleges and academic administration, and decided to go into that field as a consultant. So I left higher ed, and Deborah Lindsey happened to be a potential client because my sister, who was into paranormal studies, went to one of her events and told Deb she could do this online instead of in workshops, and she had this vision of creating a university, so she called me, and we started talking, and I got into it just on the online part of it, on the accreditation piece of it, and then found myself very, very attracted to all things metaphysical. So it's been kind of a baptism by fire, but I love it. I love being with the university. I love the people I work with, and I really like the challenge of bringing accreditation to a metaphysical school.
Excellent. Well, good for you. So, Ben, here, I guess you just wanted to finish up here with a couple of questions.
Yes, you can.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, where can people go to get information for IMU?
Well, the easiest thing to do is to go to the website. Pretty much everything's there. It's www.intermetu.com, and that's intermetu.com. And there's a section on the website where you can sign up for more information. And if you do that, you'll get updates about interesting things going on at the university. And also we can, you know, contact you if you have any questions. And you're also welcome to just call us. We're at 304-295-4411. We're there, you know, East Coast business time. You can call us anytime, or, you know, we'll call you.
Very good. And you don't want to forget that course, Paranormal Science, Religion, and the Paranormal. A certain guy teaches that. So, Susan, thoughts?
Getting into contact with us?
Yeah.
Well, the same thing as Deborah, and that would be to go to the website and look at the teachers and the deans and see what we have to offer. We're adding new classes all the time.
Great.
And I'm very excited about doing this.
Yeah, tell us about it.
You know, it's also good to know that people can take just a course. They don't have to sign up to get a degree, you know. If you want to just come on and take Paul's course, you can just come take Paul's course.
Sure.
You know, so if they want to do the science, religion, the paranormal, they can do that, you know.
Yeah.
And we also have some other wonderful classes coming up. We have this week we're going to be announcing, so you're kind of ahead of the game if you're listening to the show, but Carl Johan Kallman is one of our instructors, and Carl's class on understanding the Mayan calendar is going to be released this week. So students will be able to start taking that. And we just released Carolyn Sutherland's course on developing the eyes of the medical intuitive. So, you know, many of you might know Carolyn Sutherland. She's Louise Hay's healer. Louise Hay is, of course, the founder of Hay House.
Mm-hmm.
And so that course just came up. So those, you know, you can look and see what the different courses are that are coming up all the time. And, you know, so just sign up to get on the email list. Sign up
Great
to get time. More information. And
Excellent.
You'll find out about all the fun classes as they come up.
Very timely. Yeah.
If you go to the website, you'll be able to see all the courses that we have. We have course descriptions for the entire catalog, even those that aren't currently offered. So, you know, if you have something in mind that you'd like to take, it's probably already been developed, and you can read about it. And then when it's announced, you'll have that information.
Excellent. Okay, well, we are just about out of time here, and I wanted to thank everyone very much for being with us, Deborah, Susan, and Dr. Steve. And we'll be in touch as we go, and we'll be talking more about the International Metaphysical University. And congratulations on what you've done, what you've accomplished, and best of luck for the future.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Paul. Thank you.
Okay. We'll be working with you and talking to you. Okay.
Boy.
All right. Now, plan to listen to our three-hour special here on CBS New Sky Radio, April 11th, when we'll combine shows with our on-air neighbors here, Dave and Tom Jones from CAPS Paranormal. And we're going to co-host a UFO panel discussion to mark the 30th anniversary of the Bentwaters Air Base incident of 1980, Britain's Roswell. And we'll have UFO greats Nick Pope, Bill Burns of UFO Hunters, and Peter Robbins, along with actual witnesses to the incident. So far, we have Larry Warren and John Burroughs, former U.S. Air Force personnel, who witnessed the whole business. And, of course, you can write to us through our site, behindtheparanormal.com, at any point. Check out our schedules, our upcoming guests. Get to know a little bit about Ben and me. And you can link from there to a number of other things, find out about what we're doing and all this interesting stuff that goes on behind the paranormal. And you can also buy my books on that site. And you can subscribe to our weekly email newsletter. Okay, or you can apply to become a reporter at the site. We have 5 reporters right now covering different parts of the universe. And we always welcome new ones who are very serious about reporting on stuff in their own areas, and they're on the show relatively frequently.
All right. Podcasts of all our shows are available at newskyradio.com or at our show website, behindtheparanormal.com.
Okay, and thanks to our producer, Will Kosnick. And we will see you right here next Sunday, March 7th at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific on CBS New Sky Radio, newskyradio.com. When we will welcome back the great Murray Silver. A lot of people have been asking for Murray.
Yeah.
All sorts of fireworks usually take place when we have Murray. Murray, whom you may not have heard of, is a very, very well-known ghost hunter and author from Savannah, Georgia. He is also, however, a Hollywood insider and a Washington insider. And we're going to be talking about ghost hunting in depth, more depth than you're probably used to. But Murray is one of the great thinkers around, too. He's Mensa's top-rated speaker in America, and he's always a pleasure to listen to. And we'll get into questions that just will boggle the mind and will also sometimes get us in trouble with the government or something.
Yeah, let's say that for everybody to hear.
Well, hey, you know, I'm not afraid of them.
Well, you're also, like, too old. You're also old enough not to care.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I can, you have to help me out of here, out of this chair. Anyway.
All right. In the meantime, check out our Saturday show at 11 a.m. Eastern, 4 Pacific, on WOON 1240 a.m. in southeastern New England and onworldwide.com. Also, you can hear rebroadcasts of Behind the Paranormal on Saturday at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 Pacific, right here on CBS Radio, on CBS Psychic Radio.
And we do try to get to emails that you send. We have a form on the Behind the Paranormal website where you could write to us and ask questions or make suggestions. And a lot of people write to us asking for help, or at least asking for advice on cases that may be taking place that they believe may be paranormal. We try to get to those every show, but we don't often have, we don't always have time to do so, and we will be able to get to those, I think, on succeeding shows with a little bit more. We have a little bit fewer, maybe some you know, fewer guests. And anyway, there we are. We're gonna see you next week here on CBS New Sky Radio, and we'll talk to you then.
All right, see you then.